Freedom Party gathers under ominous skies.
What are the winds right now?
Shelley Keeler gets on the phone. The sailboat is still 30 minutes out, and there are water spouts forming near the inlet.
All right. Be safe. Bye. Okay, so everyone's sopping wet, and they just went through 40 knot winds.
10 miles away, treading in the Atlantic, is Captain David Pollitt, and the last few miles into port will be some of his toughest. It took him 3 years, but finally, he's about to finish his solo sail around the world. Just him, his dog Mango, and the open sea.
Doc, I am single-handing. Over.
Back on shore, word comes in. He's close.
Is that him?
There. The tip of the mast comes around the corner.
I can see the weather on it, because it was freshly painted when it left.
And after thousands of miles, the South Florida native is home.
He did it! Woo!
David has always wanted to explore the world.
You face an antagonistic ocean.
He tells his friends about his adventure. 50-foot waves, sharks, even pirates. But sometimes it was quiet.
You'll go from pretty rough stuff, and then suddenly it'll go like absolute glass. The whole sea, and for hundreds of miles, is totally glass.
David spent most of his time cramped inside the cabin, a tiny bedroom, an even smaller bathroom, but it kept him safe.
You can have wind, enormous wind and waves, and this is always tranquil.
Now that he's home, he plans to make a documentary about the trip, but not before celebrating with friends and family he hasn't seen in 3 long, wet years.
Well, now that he's back on solid ground, he probably won't be heading out into the water again, but his blog has inspired another local man to attempt to sail around the world by himself. We're in Riviera Beach. Randy Gyllenhaal, WPBF 25 News.